All aboard, get on board. All aboard, get on board.
There's a train coming somewhere down the track. The people that ain't ready better step in back. This train has been running since time began. It's running on the love of your fellow man. All aboard,
all aboard,
you better get on board. All aboard, child, you better get on board. People get ready, there's a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage, you just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesels humming. You don't need no ticket, you just thank the Lord. All aboard.
Sure, it's hard to believe them pretty sounds be coming from them.
Hey, Daniel, come on down on the stoop with us.
Hey, look. And if your daddy done made any more of that crackling bread, I sure would appreciate a piece.
Sure, gotcha. I'll be right down.
The Collins could have used a little more bacon fat, but I didn't want to overdo it on account of your daddy's pressure.
Then why use bacon fat at all? Everything's fine, Mama.
Well, it ain't like you, baby, just to pick at your plate.
I don't have much of an appetite.
Maybe you should go see a doctor Poe tomorrow.
I feel fine. There's nothing wrong with me.
Can't be too careful when it comes to your health. And your mother's right. It isn't like you to pick at your plate. Now, either you are not feeling well or something else is bothering you. Which is it?
I think it's time I made my own mistakes.
Hey, this is about James, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
That is one mistake I won't allow you to make. Now eat your supper.
And no matter what Martin Luther King does, he'll never bring white and color together. Never in a million years. You're starting to sound like James.
You know, sometimes I wish I was white. Boy, I bet that would be some feeling. Go anywhere you wanna, live anywhere you wanna, do anything you wanna do. If I could, I'd crawl out of this colored skin as quick as you can say, Jack Johnson.
Winky, you don't mean that.
Hey, man. Daniel, you scared me.
It's what's inside a person that makes a difference, no matter what your color is. And Steele, you're wrong about Dr. King. If it can be done, he is the one man who can bring both the whites and the Negroes together.
It won't work. It'll never work. Look what happened in Mississippi last year. It took the National Guard and even the president to step in just so this colored boy could go to college. White and colored people just aren't the same. Put us together is like putting oil and water together. We don't mix. Just look at old country here. Chewing on that old crackling bread. You think the white folks is ready for this?
What are you afraid of, Daddy?
James is elected to go astray, and I will not allow him to influence you in his evil ways. Thou shalt have no other God before thee. Let that be his measuring stick, not me.
But, Daddy, the Lord is called by many names.
Yeah, and Allah is not one of them. My God teaches the doctrine of love, not separation and hate among his creation.
And with the kind of brotherly love Dr. King professes, one day both races will learn to live together and love each as brothers.
I tell you one thing, God could have spared the colored people a lot of misery if he just made us all one color.
But hold it. Do you really believe that, Daniel? That colored people and white people can live together as brothers?
Sounds like the rhetoric of an Uncle Tom to me.
Sure is an awful surprise. We're talking about Reverend King.
I should have known.
Hey, you have no right to speak of him like that.
All James wants to do is call on me.
Don't dispute me, child. You're not to see James again, and that's final. The devil is always at work. Lord knows you have to be firm with the young ones today.
Well, sure. See you in a good while.
Yeah, you don't come around like you used to.
Yeah, I bet you're just getting in from the temple, huh? Kind of late for it, though, isn't it?
Brothers, if it's one thing that I have learned since becoming a Muslim, that a Muslim's work is never done. Say, haven't I seen you somewhere before? Yeah, I saw you down Broad Street last week, shining shoes.
Sure I was. I'm the best there is. Glad to meet you.
Sure, brother.
James? Oh, you want some crackling bread?
Yeah. Muslims don't eat that garbage.
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Leave him alone, man.
Then it's time you found out. It's you ignorant, brainwashed, so-called Negroes who are holding back the progress. Wise up and be a man.
I guess I'll be on my way.
Country, you don't have to go anywhere. I eat crackling bread and there's nothing wrong with it.
Well, it is getting kind of late. My dear, where is when I'm out too long?
Look, he's just a country boy. A few more weeks, we haven't broken him.
Well, at least he doesn't lack manners.
I'll get Patsy back down there to give you a hand with the kitchen. She knows better.
Leave her be. The child is upset.
Upset or not? I will not have her shirking her responsibilities.
Joshua, please.
Does the temple always let out so late? It's 10:30.
No, brother. I went over to Temple Number 7 in New York. I heard Minister Malcolm X teach today. My first time hearing him in person, and brother, he was something else. I wish all of you could have been there. You'd have learned something today.
Is that so?
She should be more appreciative. You put a lot of effort into this meal tonight, and a fine meal it was. And this pie is especially good. What kind is it?
Bean pie.
Bean pie, huh? Sure is good. Never had anything like it, quite like it before. I never heard of a bean pie. You know, it tastes something like potato pie. I think I'll have one more piece there, one big piece. I never knew you to cook anything like this.
I don't. James gave it to Patsy for our dinner. It's Muslim bean pie.
Well, you claim you've learned something from this Malcolm X today. All I hear is hatred.
No, brother. What you hear is love. I don't hate the white man. Nor do I love him. Let's say I understand him. And if it wasn't for his hate, I would not be bearing witness to the truth and love of self. You talk about seeing love within. How can you when the Caucasian has destroyed it with their teachings that make the Negro hate himself? Just take a look in Tommy's on any old Saturday night. Negroes drinking, fornicating, walking around with their conked and greased up hair, having no kind of respect for themselves, thinking it's hip, when in reality, they hate their hair so much they put lye in it to straighten it out. So don't speak to me about hate, because now you look at a man who loves himself, his hair, and his black skin, all because of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Well, those people have been living their lives long before you were born. You'll never know what they went through.
Brother, the truth shall set you free. You see, I don't have any use for those people or anyone else, heroes or old friends. Unless they are part of the Nation of Islam.
They all look up to you.
I mean what I said. I was just being myself.
That's just it. You weren't being yourself. At least not the James we grew up with.
If being myself means acting and grinning like some Negro, just to be a friend of Mr. Reverend Brown, then I'll leave that all to you.
So that's what's eating you? Patsy told me all about the running you had with her father.
No big thing. I expected as much.
Well, I think you should know that I'll be seeing her on a regular basis now. And I'm probably gonna take her to the prom, too.
Good for you. Then again, you are the Reverend's kind of boy.
Yeah, let's wait.
They say that falling in love is wonderful, wonderful. So they say.
Daniel, will you come upstairs for a minute? Daniel? Daniel, what's taking you so long? Come in, Daniel. Can you open this?
Sure.
Oh, no, that was a brand new pair of Dixie Peach.
I'm sorry. I'll run over to the drugstore and buy you another one.
That won't be necessary. Why are you so fidgety? Is this the first time you ever been in a girl's room?
Well, yes.
Relax, it's no big deal.
Patsy, are you up there?
It's Daddy. What are we gonna do?
I thought you said it was all right.
Think, you're in my bedroom.
Oh, God, you're right.
Under the bed.
What?
Patsy.
Get under the bed.
Patsy, I can't.
Hurry.
Well, this is not the way we should handle this.
Will you stop talking like a fool and get under the bed?
Patsy, didn't you hear me calling you?
Calling me?
Yeah.
No, Daddy.
Hey, it's James, isn't it? I know you think you're still in love with him. In time, all of these feelings will pass. Just put it in the Lord's hands and everything will be all right.
What brings you home? Is everything okay at the bazaar?
Everything's going wonderfully at the bazaar. In fact, it couldn't be better. I just came home to fetch more of your mother's peach cobbler. I hope it'll be enough. First thing we ran out of. I saw Daniel's father's car parked outside.
Oh, he'll be right back. He went to the drugstore to get me another jar of Dixie Peach. I had a little accident.
Well, couldn't that have waited?
You know Daniel. He's always offering to do for others, no matter how hard you try to stop him.
Yeah, I think I know Daniel a whole lot better than you do. Going to the store was his polite way of respecting my rules concerning mail callers. That's why you should be dressed and ready when he calls on you.
Yes, Daddy.
Daniel is a true gentleman. Say, better get this up before you slip and hurt yourself.
Daddy, I could do that. I have to hurry before Daniel gets back.
Of course, but you can be sure to get that up. That can cause a pretty nasty fall.
Yes, Daddy, I will.
Well, I better get back to the bazaar, you know? Liberty Baptist has not done this well, selling dinners in years, and a large part of it is due to your mother's cobbler. I expect to see you and Daniel before shortly, right? Okay. Wouldn't you seem right if the Reverend's daughter didn't show up for the church bazaar?
Okay, you can get out now.
Oh, I thought for sure you'd heard my heart pounding. I don't see why we couldn't have just told him the truth. I guess honesty doesn't come easy to you, does it? Why didn't you tell me about you and James? You didn't have to lead me on.
What about the bazaar? Daddy expects us to be there.
Well, I'm sure you'll think of something.
Put a spell on you. Because you're mine. Stop the things you do. the things you do. What's up? I ain't lying. Oh! Oh! I love you. I love you. I love you. Anyhow, I don't care if you don't want me. I'm yours right now. I put a spell on you.
Wish y'all hadn't have come and got me. Sure as I'm standing here, the police gonna come looking for us tomorrow.
Don't get cold feet now, country. You said you could use the money, didn't you?
I reckon so, but I never thought it would mean breaking the law.
You ain't got nothing to be afraid of, country. You're just gonna be our lookout. You're not gonna touch a thing.
Y'all never include me on anything much. Why this time?
The truth is, country, we choose you because nobody can see you at night.
I ain't playing with you, Steel.
Hey, Steel, not tonight. We don't need this.
Yeah, Winky's right. You all know that this is one black country boy. Hell, he ain't even dark-skinned. He's black. Blue-black. And if there's anything worse than a country boy, is one with peasy head. A black country boy. Y'all know he had to ask Charlotte to the prom? She's half white. Ain't no way she's going to the prom with him as black as she is.
My mama ain't never spawned nothing black.
Your mama had you, didn't she?
Leave him alone, Steel. You're just jealous because Charlotte turned you down.
Hey, for your information, I'm taking Velma. Mm-hmm. That rich daddy of hers just bought her a brand new Thunderbird. I'm going to be driving in high style. So, black boy, you might as well find someone else. You think her parents want you around darkening up the family?
Oh, see what you went and done. Hey, country, where you going? Steel was only playing.
That's right. Don't pay Steel no mind. We need you. Do it for me and Winky. Like you said, you could use the money.
Steel, no, I don't play like that. I'm as a Negro, a color. I ain't black.
Look, lady for Steel, are you with us? Okay, now come on, let's get moving. And remember, don't forget, country, one whistle for foot patrol and two for car patrol. Got it?
I got it.
When I was a little boy,
when I was just a boy,
and the devil would call my name.